this video, I'll explain the topics creep and kink formed in railway track. So basically, creep is defined as the longitudinal movement of the rail with respect to the sleepers. Okay, so whenever there is a longitudinal movement in the rails, that movement is known as creep. So how do we clearly understand that creep has occurred, or what indications are given such that we realize that a creep has been formed? So what happens is, there is a closing of successive expansion spaces at the rail joint. You can see here, a rail joint is there. There is a gap in between the rails. If in case the gap gets decreased or the gap is getting closed, then of course it means that creep has occurred. Or some cases what happens is, the opening of joints occurs. If there is an opening of joint, there also we can say that it is because of the longitudinal movement of rail. So this is basically what creep is. Okay, now coming to the defect of creep, what happens is, the sleepers actually will be intact, but because of the creep, the position of the sleepers move out. In the figure you can see, this is the actual position of the sleepers since creep is formed. Okay, this is the direction of creep, and because of this, what happens is, the position of sleepers is getting disturbed. Okay, if this happens, the alignment problems comes, gauge problems come, and interlocking mechanism gets disturbed. And not only that, the points and crossings are getting disturbed. Points and crossings means it is the junction where a track is getting diverted from another. So there also problems will occur. Coming to causes of creep, ironing out effect of moving wheel on waves formed on the rail. Tendency of wheel to push rail forward and backward due to acceleration, deceleration and running. So basically the causes of creep are defined or is explained on the basis of three theories. In that, one is the wave theory, second is the percussion theory, and third one is the drag theory. The wave theory says that whenever a wheel is moving on a track, what happens is, the position where the wheel forms or where the wheel is loaded, in that portion a depression will be formed and the nearby ends will be having a lift or a bulge will be formed. And whenever the moving train continuously moves, this wave action will be formed throughout. So this causes a longitudinal movement in the rail. Second theory, that is a percussion theory, states that creep is formed due to the impact of wheel at the rail end ahead at the joints. Okay, so that means at the joint, you will be having a trailing rail and you will be having a facing rail, which means trailing rail is the rail which is left behind and facing rail is the rail on which the wheel is going to move. So what happens is, at this joint, it pushes the rail forward, which results in creep. Okay, so this is explained in the percussion theory. And in the third theory, that is the drag theory, it states that backward thrust on driving the wheel of the locomotive of the train has tendency to push the rail of the track backward. Okay, so these are some causes of the creep. So you can see the wave theory of creep in this, whereby you can see a wheel and where the wheel is being formed, or where the wheel falls on the rail, it forms a depression, and nearby preceding thing and succeeding thing, you can see lift. Okay, this shows that this is the direction of motion. When the train starts to move, or it is the train starting point, what happens is, during starting point, the wheel pushes the rail backward, and during stopping, the wheel pushes the rail forward. Okay, so this is shown in the figure. When the train stops, this will be direction of motion. Actually, this is the motion and it is trying to stop. This will cause a creep in this direction, and when it is a starting point, what happens is, the wheel tries to push the rail backward. Okay, in the case of train when it is going to start, and when the train when it is going to stop, it pushes the rail forward. So direction of creep as well as direction of motion will be same over here. Then comes the remedies or prevention of creep. So the remedies in that, first one, it is pulling back of rail. So here, if the creep is distinctly visible, the remedy is to pull back the rail to their original position. For doing this, first we have to inspect the track, note the extent of pulling back distance, and we have to determine that. And what is done is, the workers will come and they will use crowbar, hooks, etc. And they will try to keep the or pull the rail in exact position. Then is the provision of anchors or anti-creepers. So the creep of track can be prevented by using them. If there is a creep of 7.5 centimeters to 15 centimeters, then in a month, around 4 anchors per rail is being used. And if there is a creep of around 22.5 centimeters to 25 centimeters, around 6 anchors per rail is used in Indian practice. So these anchors are fastened to the foot of rail and they are kept in perfect contact so that the creep forming will be reduced. You can see this. These are the anti-creepers, or these are the anchors which are being laid such that the rail is being firmly connected with the sleeper. Then another remedy is that we can also use steel sleepers. If steel sleepers are used, then it will be much more stable and the longitudinal movements of rail can be reduced. Then comes the kink of rail. When the ends of adjoining rails move out of position, then shoulders or kinks are formed. Okay, so kinks, we can also say, like, if there is a lateral shift in the rail due to loose joint, then it is also known as kink. You can see here the ends of adjoining rail, they move out of the position slightly, and this is known as kink. Now, causes of kink are loose packing at joints. This loose packing means, or packing means that it is a method of forcing stone ballast below the sleepers. If in case the joints are not strong enough, then what happens is sufficient stability is not given to the rail, then these deformations happens in the rail. So this is one of the cause for the kink formation, that is loose packing at the joint. Then defect in gauge and alignment. If the alignment is not properly done, or if the gauge, some gauge distance problem is there, if some defect is there, then what happens is kinks will be formed. Okay, kink is what? It is a lateral shift in the rail. Then we can also say that uneven wear of rail head. If the wearing of rail happens more than the usual one, what happens is it can also cause kink. What you can see here is the kink formation. Okay, that is that at the joints, you can see that these are the joints, there is an excess gauge formed. This is the proper gauge length which is to be maintained. This is the left hand side of the rail and this is the right hand side of the rail. So if it is properly maintained, you will be having a proper gauge length. But when kinks are formed, you will be having excess gauge. Okay, so because of this, when you are traveling, or if the train is moving on these kind of regions, you will be having an unpleasant jerk. Okay, then there will be defect in the gauge. Again, because of this formation of kink, you will be having defect in the gauge, then alignment, and also in the camber. Not only that, there will be an enlargement at the joint. So because of all these reasons, you can have an unpleasant jerk when the vehicle is moving over them. Then what are the measures taken to rectify kink in rail? So what we can do is, we can properly pack the joints. I told you in the beginning that since the joints are not properly packed, this kind of deformations, this kind of lateral shift occurs. So we can properly pack the joints. Correcting the alignments of joints. So if in case the joints are not being given correct alignment, then we can correct the alignment. Then another thing which is to be strictly maintained is the proper maintenance of the track periodically. Okay, so in all the places, track should be periodically maintained at the cross levels. You have to check the gauge length, the alignment. You have to check whether there is wearing out of railhead, if there is wearing out, then surely there can be a possibility of kink. So if you are periodically maintaining them, then no such formation of kinks will be there. So you can take the measures to rectify them. And if in case you notice that some portions are worn out, you can weld those portions. From this, what we can say is, if the track is properly maintained or if it is maintained periodically, then the formation of kink as well as creep can be reduced to a large extent.